This is the calculus version of how to find the equation of a tangent line. So we want a parametric equation, and the curve that we have is described by this at this point. So here we go. We can write this down as r of t. So that's our factor function. So we have the x component, y component, and also the z component. Then we have to figure out what t value are we talking about. Look at the z is t, which is just pi over 2. So the t value is clearly pi over 2. And of course, you can also plug in pi over 2 into this t and that t. We will get 0 and 1. And of course, just like the good old days, to find the equation of a tangent line, or a line in general, we need a slope and a point. We have the point already, and the slope is just the derivative. So it's pretty much the same idea. So let's go ahead and differentiate this. We will have negative 2 sine t, and then that will give us cosine t, and then that will give us 1. Next, plug in pi over 2. So r prime of pi over 2. When we plug in pi over 2 to here, sine of pi over 2 is 1, and then we have negative 2. And then cosine of pi over 2 is 0, and then 1 is just 1. So now, here's the idea. You can treat this as the slope, and this right here is the point. And whenever you're trying to find the equation of a line through this point, parallel to this factor, all you have to do is the following. I'm just going to write this down right here for you guys. Here we have the answer. X is going to be our initial x value. This is the x0, which is just 0. And then we add this value multiplied by t. So it's negative 2 times t. And of course, that's just negative 2t. And then for y, we start at 1, and we add 0 times t. Of course, that's just 0, so we just have 1. And lastly, z equals pi over 2 plus 1 times t. So that's just pi over 2 over pi over 2 plus t. So this right here will be the parametric equations for the tangent line. All right, another one. So let's go ahead and put this into the factor function form. So we have the x component, y component, and also the z component. All right, let's go ahead and take the derivative. So we will get 2t. And remember, the derivative of square root of t will give us 1 over 2 square root of t. And then multiply by 4, so that will give us 2 over square root of t. And then lastly, the derivative of this, it repeats e to the t squared minus t, but of course use the chain rule, so multiply by 2t minus 1 for the derivative of that. Okay, and in fact, we should also look at here and then kind of figure out what we need, right? And in fact, you can just look at it. You can see that this right here, the t value that we care is 1. Because if you put t squared plus 1 to be 2, t is plus or minus 1. But if you put 1 right here, it works, right? But negative 1 doesn't work because square root of negative 1 is not a real number. And if you have 1 squared minus 1 is 0, e to the 0 is equal to 1. So the t value that we want in this case is 1. And now, go ahead and get the derivative at 1. So plugging 1, we get 2. Plugging 1, we get another 2. Plugging 1, okay, this is 2 times 1, which is 2 minus 1, which is 1. And then plugging 1, so that's e to the 0's power times 2 minus 1. So it's again 1, so it's 2, 2, 1. Now, we'll just do what we did earlier. So here is the tangent line equation in the parametric form. So x equals our starting, which is 2, plus this 2 times t. Yeah, that's pretty much it. And then y equals 4 plus that 2 times t. And lastly, z equals 1. Plus 1t, which is just t. Just like that. And that will do it. All right, one more example for you guys. Here we go. let's write this as r of t. We have the x component, y component, and also the z component. All right, and we have to figure out the t value. And I am just going to look at the z component. We can see that it has to be 0. E to the negative 0 is 1. So t is equal to 0. And now, the hard part for this one right here is the derivative. Make sure you use the product rule and also the chain rule for this one right here. So let's go ahead and do it. I will keep the first function, multiply by the derivative of the second, and then plus the second function times the derivative of the first. So that will give us e to the negative t. And remember the chain rule, we have to multiply by negative 1. So that's the x component. And then I'm going to try to fit this in here. So next one, pretty much the same thing, e to the negative t, and then times the derivative of that, plus the second function, times the derivative of the first, which is e to the negative t, negative 1. And then the last one is going to be e to the negative t times negative 1. So yeah, kind of fitting here. All right, now plugging 0. So this question is actually pretty nice because we are using 0. So check this out. When we plug in 0, sine 0 is 0, so that part doesn't matter. This is 1 times negative 1, and cosine 0 is 1, so all in all, we get negative 1. Next, plug in 0, that part wouldn't matter. Cosine 0 is 1 times that is 1, so 1. Lastly, plug in 0, e to the 0 is 1, but that's negative, so it's negative 1. So, 3 very nice numbers. Well, technically 2, because it's just negative 1 and 1. And now, we can construct our answer. X is equal to starting at 1, and then we add negative 1 times t, which is negative t. Next, y, of course, 0 doesn't matter. So we just have 1 times t, which is t. Lastly, z, 1, and then plus negative 1 times t, so just minus t. So there we go. That will do it.